In this video, I'm going to show you how to get live stats from your Deye Inverter into Home Assistant using Modbus RTU with the help of an Elfin EW11A RS485-to-WiFi adapter. Now, there are a few different ways to pull data from a Deye Inverter into Home Assistant. By far the easiest is the Solarman integration. It works out of the box for basic stats. But if you want more detailed information, and especially if you want to control or change inverter settings directly from Home Assistant, then Modbus is the way to go. And the nice thing is that the Deye inverters already have a built-in Modbus RTU port. To connect to it, you'll need a shielded twisted pair Ethernet cable with an RJ45 connector. Ethernet cables use one of two wiring standards, T568A or T568B. Most ready-made cables use T568B. You'll cut the RJ45 connector on one end and then plug the remaining RJ45 connector into the inverter's R8485 port. Different Deye inverters use different pairs of wires for RS485. In my case, I can use either pins 1 and 2 or pins 7 and 8. You can check your inverter's user manual. There's an appendix that shows the RJ45 port pin definitions for RS485, or just look up your specific model online. I'm using an Elfin EW11A because I already had one from a previous setup with a Huawei inverter. And honestly, when I searched online, I didn't find a single tutorial showing how to connect the Elfin to a Deye inverter. So I just experimented, and eventually I got it working. Most people use an ESP32 with a Modbus RTU adapter and ESP Home or a Raspberry Pi, and those methods work great. But since I already had the Elfin lying around, I didn't want to buy new hardware. So here's how the wiring works. You'll plug the RJ45 end of the cable into the RS485 port on your Deye inverter. On the other side of the cable, where you cut the connector, you'll take the pair of wires your inverter manual specifies. In my case, it was pins 1 and 2, white, orange, and orange. Connect those wires to the A and B terminals on the Elfin. In the middle, you'll also connect the power supply for the Elfin. It accepts anything from 5 to 36 volts DC. I'm using a 12 volt DIN rail power supply rated at around 2 amps, which is more than enough. Once the wiring is done, let's switch to the network setup. On your computer, look for the Elfin's Wi-Fi. It shows up as something like EW11 underscore. Connect to it. Its default IP address is 10.10.100.254. Open a browser, go to that address, and log in using the default username and password, admin and admin. The first thing you want to do is go to System Settings and connect the Elfin to your own Wi-Fi network. Enter your Wi-Fi name and password, click Submit, and then restart the device. After it reconnects, check your router to find out which IP address it got from the HTTP. Once you're connected to the Elfin through your home network, we'll set up the serial port. Use the following settings. Baud rate, 9600. Data bits, 8. Stop bit, 1. Parity, none. And set the protocol to Modbus. Click Submit, and you can leave the rest of the default settings as they are. Next, go to Communication Settings. Set the protocol to TCP Server and the port to 502. Everything else can stay as it is. Submit the changes, and that's all the configuration needed on the Elfin side. Now, let's move into Home Assistant. For this to work, you'll need to have MQTT set up beforehand. Go to Add-ons and install the Sunsynk Deye Inverter add-on, to which I'll leave a link in the description. In the add-on settings, set the inverter driver to Pi Modbus. Under Inverters, click the Edit button. Enter your inverter's serial number, the Home Assistant prefix you want to use, the Modbus ID from your inverter interface, and the IP and port of the Elfin using TCP. Save the settings. Under sensor definitions, choose the correct type for your inverter, single phase in my case. Set the manufacturer to Deye. Save everything. Start the add-on and make sure to enable the watchdog so it automatically restarts if anything crashes. Check the logs to confirm that the add-on successfully connected to your inverter. Now, go to Settings, Devices and Services, and search for the prefix you configured. In my case, it's Deye_10K. It should show up as an MQTT device. Click on it, and you should now see all the sensors and configuration options exposed through the add-on. If you're not getting any data, the very first thing to check is the wiring. Try swapping the two wires going from the inverter to the Elfin. So instead of white, orange, orange on A and orange on B, flip them. Orange to A and white, orange to B. After swapping them, watch the serial port status page in the Elfin interface. You should see the traffic count increasing immediately. As I said earlier, there are several ways to connect a Deye inverter to Home Assistant. I used the Solarman integration before, and it worked fine for basic monitoring. But since I already had the Elfin, I wanted to try the full Modbus approach. The main difference is that Solarman only gives you stats. You can't change any settings. With the Modbus RTU add-on, you'll get full control. You can enable or disable grid charging, set load limits, configure charging schedules, and even turn solar export on and off. All the same settings you can do from your inverter's own interface. I really hope this video helps someone out there. If you found it useful, please hit the like button, and if you'd like to see more videos like this, consider subscribing. Thank you for watching, and until next time, all the best.